Hi all. Today I will be sharing the most important tips. The three key tips that will ensure that your resume gets shortlisted for that dream internship, that dream job, or that dream scholarship that you have been wanting to get for so long. Follow along in the video to learn the three key tips that will help you achieve and reach the goals that you have set for yourself. Hi everyone, this is Drishti Jain, and I know that as a student, as a fresher, or even as somebody who's in their career midway, it becomes very frustrating and difficult when you have been applying for days and days for the job of your dreams, but you do not hear back. Have you ever thought that maybe your skill set is not reaching the eyes of the recruiter or the engineering manager that who has posted the particular job that you have applied for? I believe we should take a step back and look at the thing that we submit to them at the first place. You have a ton of skills, but are you able to correctly showcase it to them or not? So resume is what you should give another glance at. You see, resume is the most important piece of paper when you're applying for your dream job, scholarship, or internship. The tips that I'll be sharing you today, having won a ton of scholarships, worked at the top firms, the top product-based companies, there are many key things that get unnoticed by somebody who's new to the space or is trying to move into their dream space. Resume is a piece of paper that tells the world, the recruiter, the hiring manager, about what to expect when they interview you, or is it the right match for what they're looking for? Most important tip, that is, use action verbs to describe any and every activity on your resume, be it your experience, your personal projects, or your leadership qualities, something you did outside of your regular day job. You will be describing a couple of sentences about it in bullet points. But it is important that you start with an action verb, because there was some kind of an action, some kind of a thing that you did. So starting it with an action verb will help enable the one who's viewing the resume to know what to expect. For example, if you were able to deliver results to a client, starting your sentence with "delivered so and so results for my client, which was able to optimize their efficiency by some percentage," instead of just blatantly explaining what you did. You see, action verbs, the first word that they hear, they should be able to get a sense of what they are going to read in the sentence in the next few words. So the key point is to always start the description of any experience, project, or any other section in your resume with an action verb. Believe me, it might take some hours of your time to change your resume to start with action verbs, but it is all worth it. It will make your resume replicate and portray the skills and the achievements that you have done. The second important point that will help your resume reach the eyes of any and everyone is to never include "I" or "me" in your resume. Yes, you heard it right. See, the one who's viewing your resume knows that the name mentioned is the person who's done the things in the resume mentioned. So you do not have to reiterate that you did it, saying that I won a competition, I won so and so award at my organization, I was able to reduce false positives in my model. You do not have to start the sentence with "I" or include "I" anywhere. That is wrong. It will not give the impression of what you did. Instead of having the focus of the reader to the thing that you did, for example, reduce the false positives of a model, it would keep an emphasis on "I." See, here itself, using the first point and this point, you can turn this sentence into "reduced false positives of model by a particular percentage. It instead of saying, I reduced the false positives of my model. Everybody knows that what you're trying to say is all already there in your resume. So never use I or me. Try and reframe your sentences such that you are portraying the right thing as well as in the right way. Woohoo! So seems like using the two tips shared, you are going to become a pro. Wait a second. This one very, very important thing. So tell me, whenever you go out, whether you are making a purchase, eating food, what is the first thing that makes a particular product or a service appeal to you? It is the visual appearance, right? So why don't you apply this to your resume as well? So here comes the third very important tip. It is to keep your resume visually balanced. So what do I mean by visually balanced? Listen carefully. This is a very, very important tip that nobody shares, that nobody tells you is what made their resume get into the door of those fan companies you have been targeting. Visually appealing resume or having your resume visually balanced means that at a glance, there have been numerous studies which have shown that an average recruiter looks at your resume for 4 to 8 seconds, generally 6 seconds. So why will they look at your resume? Do they find that all of your resume is very empty? There's a lot of white space. Just do not focus on the words, look at your resume. And if you find a ton of white spaces, so it might give an impression that maybe you do not have enough or the right experience. There aren't a lot of skills that you were able to show on your resume. That's why it has a lot of white space. So that is an example of a non-visually balanced resume. Avoid doing that. Also, it might be possible that you have your name, your initial details, education details, skills, and then your experience section. And while looking at it, at a glance, it looks like 75% of your one-page resume is all filled only with experience. That isn't visually balanced either, because it does not let the viewer know that you have some sort of a soft skill or a leadership skill. Having your resume visually balanced such that if a person just looks at the key points, even at that point, the person will be able to see, okay, this person has these 5 or 6 sections in their resume. So having sections, not leaving out a lot of white space, but it comes with a word of caution. You have to leave enough space such that it is not a lot crumbled up. You might want to remove things or use better words, which mean things that you might be using multiple words for. So I hope you will include this tip in your resume of keeping it visually balanced. As soon as you see somebody's resume that is very visually balanced, it does not mean that you have to include colors in your resume. A black and white resume works as well. It is about how does it appeal to your eye? Does it look impressive? Does it have the right amount of sections in your resume based on the job you're applying for? Maybe you're applying for a core tech job, or maybe you're applying for a sales or a marketing job. So it depends what kind of sections are relevant for each of the job roles and how do you inculcate them. So remember to keep it very visually balanced. And since you've made this far in the video and looking at the keen interest you have to achieve your dream job, here is a bonus tip. In doing all of these things, many a times we forget the most important way. How would somebody who is impressed by you, your skills, your achievements, your experience, contact you? Right? Just because you have to fit it in one page, you want space in your resume, but it might lead to you forgetting the most important thing. How does a person contact you? Your email ID. That is the core important thing. Just mentioning your Twitter handle or your LinkedIn profile would not work. You should always have your email ID, be it your school, personal, professional email ID, but some way, some point of contact that the viewer of the resume, the recruiter, the manager should know so that they can contact you. even if you do not have the contact number, that's completely okay. But having your email ID on your resume is the most important thing. Whether you have your other social media handles or not, due to some space constraint, but your email ID should be there right on top along with your name. So it's now time that you use these three tips and the bonus tip to make your resume shine. And if you have liked this video, hope this video helps you, do like the video, share it with your friends who might also benefit from this, and subscribe to continue learning more. Thank you.